But I've just come to Uganda maybe 4 months ago. So I'm very new to the Rapid community, and I'll probably jump straight into just demoing some of the newer features that we just started rolling out. If MTN cooperates, this can actually be quite interactive, so I'd like to ask everybody to take all their phones out, if you have them. It's a toll-free short code, so I'm not going to make you send any text messages that cost money. And if they're on silent, please actually take them off silent. That's mostly for my own entertainment. This is the short code. It's 6767. Apparently Mountain Dew is running a campaign right now with 6777, so we get a lot of these people trying to win prizes. But anyway, just text anything you want into that number, join, and it will give you a response back. That'll kind of get you in the system because I'm going to be asking you a few more questions as we go through the demo. Just to give you a bit of background about the features that I'm demoing today, you know, I can't speak to the state of the RapidSMS community for the past few years, but as it currently stands, it's actually really phenomenal as an open source community. The modules I'm going to be showing you today were built by developers in Mali, Rwanda, two organizations here, France, New York, and it's really great how all these people have come together, and we're all writing modules that all kind of work together. All right, so it sounds like a few people got messages back. Maybe MTN is being nice to me today. Anyone else? Can you put your hands up if you get a message back? All right, so we've got a few. All right. So the first one I want to show you, the first feature, this is a new module that is still kind of in development, which gives me a great excuse if anything breaks, is about structured data. Because what I've seen is that a lot of the projects around SMS are usually based around replacing paper-based forms. You know, pen and paper methods of gathering data from the field and getting very structured data to where it needs to go in a quicker amount of time and to the people that can take action on it and make that whole collation process easier. So the name of this module is XForms, which is kind of a misnomer. You should just think of it as a form. And I kind of just want to show you that it's a generic module, so I think it works in a lot of different sectors. I want to get you thinking about the sorts of things that you can do with an application like this. But we're going to start with a very simple form because, again, these sorts of campaigns have a huge training cost. You have to go out in the field and train people on how to send very structured, very complicated messages to get the data in a format that you can use. You also have to write custom code to give them feedback if they've sent you it in a format that isn't quite understood or what have you. So I think this kind of covers those sorts of use cases, which is, again, what I've seen a lot of the SMS campaigns doing most of the time. And I'll show you another feature that's kind of the other end of the spectrum. So this is the XForms screen. I haven't made any XForms. So I'm going to create one. And I'm just going to call it test. Now, you can read. I don't think anybody can read this, but it says keyword. So basically every form, this is, you know, think about this as being a piece of paper that I'm replacing. So this would be the name of the entire form. It's also the first word that the text message will start with. So it's test in this case. Testing form for name and age, response, thank you. Okay. So that seemed fairly easy, but I'm just going to make a form with two fields. Basically, I just want to get your first name, if that's not too much of an invasion of privacy, and your age, which you're welcome to lie about. So I'm going to set that up. We got name, and the type of data we're expecting is a string. Command is another thing that has to do with the message format itself. Again, I'm going to show you, this has a somewhat complicated message structure. The person's first name. So we'll add that. And then I'm going to add one more field, age. Age. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you how this works from the message tester, which just lets you kind of send a test message as if it was going into the system. but also show you this format again, so don't worry about memorizing it. But I would type in test, name, dated, and my age is 50 years old.
Looking good.
Diet and exercise. Okay, so did that go through? Yes, it went through. It responded with thank you. You can see down here. And if I go back to the X form, I can see my response. This gives you it's just a basic visualization for you know, if you see some data that seems off, you say, I know Dave, that just doesn't sound quite right. Let me call him up and see if he entered a typo and audit this data. So they'd have a 5-minute conversation with me, and based on my maturity level, they would say 5. Okay, let's save that submission. There we go. So now what I'd like all of you to do is try and do the same thing. So same number, 6767. If you can send in a text like that. Anyone? And again, I think, you know, this app is still in development, but this plus sign, I think, is going to be really challenging for some people on their phones. And, you know, for me as a developer, I think, wow, you know, there's an actual cost to me developing an app that has a plus sign in it in training. Because, you know, you're in a room with 20 people in a village. They each have a different phone. And now they have to go, where's the plus sign? On some phones, it takes 10 button presses to get to the plus sign. So that's actually going to be more configurable later on. This is still sort of in development. Is anybody getting a thank you response? Can you raise your hands? Now, the reason it's called X Forms for anybody that's got a fancy phone is that this also does expose an actual X form for anybody that knows what that is. It's if you have Open Data Kit on an Android phone that's internet enabled, you can browse to this thing and enter a submission that way as well. Looks like we've got 3 other submissions. 3 submissions. Okay. And they look fairly empty. Okay. Oh, you know, I'm sorry, let me bring the example message back up. That'd be helpful, wouldn't it? Okay, I'll wait a couple more minutes. So let's look at the opposite end of the spectrum. What if you just have one indicator that's really, really valuable in and of itself? How do you get a group of people that you've never trained and barely know how to send a text message to gather meaningful information from them? So we're going to do that now. This is a poll app. This was developed in our office about a month ago. And there's several types here, but it's all basic stuff. Now this is a simple question. And we want to train free answers, right? So we're going to do free form, but there's also yes-no response, numeric-based, location-based. You know, what district are you in? What city is this happening in? And then name registration-based, where you can actually ask someone what their name is, and whatever they respond back with will be immediately, you know, tied into their contact in the system. So I'm going to call this poll Alphabet Soup. So this has been an M4D conference, and I know just in tech alone, we're big culprits of having a lot of acronyms, like SMS, and about 1,000 others. And every sector has its own. So the question I'm going to ask is, what is the acronym or term you heard the Now this should be the fun part, because hopefully, if you text it into the short code, sorry, I'm working with a laptop, I'm going to lose students. Alright, so we're going to start this poll. Okay, wow, 152 participants. So you should all be getting that question now, and you can respond with as many terms as you want. I'll wait a little while for that to happen. I needed to have like a dance routine prepared for all these phone interactions. One response? Actually, while waiting, I can take you over to our lab system, where we've actually been collaborating with Uganda Boy Scouts Association, and we've been doing a few polls that already have results. And typically what we find is we send it out to about 1,900 people, 2,000 now, and we get typically 100 responses within the first 20 minutes, which is really great. You know, again, this isn't necessarily great structured data. It may not be very reliable data, but it's very timely data, which has its uses. The latest one we did was a yes or no poll on do children in your family sleep under a mosquito net at home? They said yes or no. We got 370 responses, and 58% yes, 41% no. Okay, so we got 20 responses. That's pretty good. Now again, I think, you know, the visualizations are eventually going to come. Right now, all of our scouts, we don't have a tag for a particular location on the map, so we can't actually show the results broken out by location. We've just pulled about 70 of them to get the district. And, you know, eventually we're going to have a visualization that looks like this for the categories of data. This is yes and no on a map. That's the eventual idea, right? But for now, because we've done a freeform poll, I'm just basically looking at words. I'm going to show you one of the visualizations that we did put up today, which is a tag cloud. And let's see what comes up. SMS. Well, that's not surprising. UNICEF. M4D. SMS. Test. Davis. Rapid. Front. Six. Frontline. Okay. Let's refresh that. Anybody else sending in, or are we pretty much all set with that? Okay, so I think, you know, what I'm trying to show is two sides of the spectrum. You know, one is you've got very structured data, you're replacing a paper-based form, and you're going to have huge training costs involved. And the other end is you just have one key indicator that you really think will give you some meaningful kind of snapshot of what's going on in some area. And if you can find a way to strategically phrase it as a yes or no or a numeric response, you can get quick time of data. Fairly easily in your training. So those are the two features I want to show you for RapidSMS. I'll be over somewhere at one of these stations for a focused Q&A and anything about the history of previous projects or current projects that RapidSMS is doing. But this is sort of the main stuff that we're working on here in Uganda. So thanks a lot for helping out with the